Hello and welcome to the Invoice Module Overview. So in this video, we're going to be looking at how you can create a single invoice, but also how you can create an invoice from a completed job sheet or from a quote. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go to the Invoice Module and create a single invoice. So if we go up to the top here, where there's a pound sign, we've got the Invoices Module. If we click on that and then we go to New, we have some options. The options are creating a new invoice from a template that you may have created and it will copy that template, or a credit note. We're going to look at new invoice. And the first thing you're going to do is you're going to start typing in the customer that you're wanting to invoice. Once that's filled in, it's just a case of really just filling in the rest of the details. So for example, the category of the invoice, the customer reference, which could be a purchase order number, for example, or a reference number that you prefer. The next bit really is then filling in the items that you're going to be invoicing. So to do that, we go to details at the bottom here, we go to invoice items, and we go to add from products. And then what we're going to do is we're going to select that product. So I've selected one here, and I'm going to click add to invoice, and that'll be added to my invoice. If we click on close, we'll now see that product in there. Once you're happy with that, you then may go to notes and you might start typing in a little bit more information about that invoice. You can then go to activity where you can see that if it's linked to a quote, a sales order, job, purchase, projects, contract, or a credit. You'll be able to also create those links from here as well, retrospectively. So you can go to quotes and you can go to link, existing quote. You can even create a new quote from here too. You can go to sales orders and you can do the same. You can go to link, and you can go to existing sales order, or you can create a new sales order. You can also add items from an existing sales order right into your invoice as well. If you go to jobs, you can do the same. You can link to an existing job and you can link to a new job. And you can also add items from an existing job as well. You can go to purchases and you can go to new and you can create a purchase order from this invoice. You can also go to projects, and you can link it to an existing project or actually create a new project. And again, you can go to contracts and you could create a new contract using the wizard or a new contract when it's blank and you'll be filling in the contract details. You've then got the last tab, which is credits, where again, you can go to new and you create a credit note from that invoice. The next tab is links and it will just confirm the links that you have created from other modules. So for example, you will see the job sheets, the quotes, and all the contracts all in one place in here. The next tab is user fields. You will see any user fields that you created for invoicing, if you have created user fields for invoicing. And then the next tab and the last tab is the comms history for that invoice. So from here, you could actually put in a new call or new callback when a customer calls to discuss this particular invoice. The next bit that you would like to do and probably will do is email it or print off this invoice. So what you can do is you can go to tools at the top and you can go to email and invoices PDF. That will open up the email and you'll be able to invoice that PDF straight away. You can also just print off that particular invoice and you'll be able to see what it looks like. And it will open up all the templates you have. You can select the template you require, you press OK, and it will come up with a printed invoice. And even from here, you can save it as a PDF and you could also email it still. But more importantly, you can also print it by clicking on the print document icon on the top left hand side of the print preview. Okay, so that's how you would create a single invoice. Now what we're going to do is we're also going to create an invoice from a job sheet. So let's go to the jobs module. And then we're going to look at a completed job. So I've made my filters here. I've got it complete. We're going to click on that job. We're going to go into the activity of that job where we've got sales, invoice, credits, and you'll see the first tab which says new invoice. So what I can do is I can create an invoice for this completed job. There is also another button which is add to existing invoice. So if you created the invoice already for this particular customer and you wanted to do it that way, you could do it that way too. And you can also link it to an existing invoice here as well. But we're going to create new invoice and we're going to create using the default settings, which is actually all items. Now, there are some other selections here. So a blank invoice is basically blank. You'd have to fill it all in again. Total for labor, materials and miscellaneous is in three categories. And then selected items, you'll be able to select the items that you want to be invoiced. All items is all items. All items with travel grouped up together. And as a single item, so one line with selected items or all items of that job sheet. We're just going to go to using default settings. So as you can see, it's pulled over all the items from that job sheet. Now you will be able to post this invoice, print this invoice, or send it as an email. So to post it, you can just go to Tools and you can click on Post to Accounts. And then once you're really finished with that invoice and you want to mark it as paid, again, you just go to Tools again and you go to Mark Invoice as Paid. Now let's do that again, but we're going to do it from the quote. So we're going to close this and we're going to go to the quotes module. So if we go to the quotes module, we're going to select a quote that has been complete. And the job may have been completed for this quote and you might want to invoice directly from the quote instead. So what we're going to do is, again, we're going to go to activity in the quote. But this time we're going to go to sales invoice credits. We're going to click on new invoice. And again, we're going to use all items, which is in this case the default setting as well. So that is now created my invoice from the quote. Now it's possible what you might want to do is also link it to a job that's existing for that particular customer. So you know that the job has been invoiced as well because it has directly come from the quote. And to do that, you can simply again go to activity, you can go to jobs, and then you could go to link existing job and find the job that is registered with that particular quote and invoice. So you just select that job, click OK, and now everything will be linked. So let's go back to that invoice and just have a little look to see what it looks like now. So if we go back to that invoice, you'll be able to go to links and you'll see that it's linked to the job and it's linked to the quote. And then again, you can go ahead and you can print off your invoice or go to Tools, Post to Accounts, and Mark Invoice as Paid if you require it to. Okay, that's it for the invoice module overview. Thanks very much for listening.